Vsauce, Kevin here. This ant needs to get to the end of this 20 centimeter rubber rope. It's really more of an elastic latex string, but work with me here. If he moves 5 centimeters per second, he'll get there in 1, 2, 3, 4 seconds. Okay, no paradox there. But what if, as the ant walks 5 centimeters per second, I stretch the rope 10 centimeters per second? Will he ever get to the end of the rope and fulfill his ultimate ant ambitions? Ant-bitions? It doesn't seem like it. It actually seems completely impossible. How could he ever reach the end of the rope if I'm increasing the distance he needs to travel by more than his progress? Oh, also, this ant's name is Billy. Speaking of ants, I started reading about them and found out that some ant queens can live for 28 or 30 years, which means there are ants alive today that were 10 years old when the first Harry Potter came out. Voice cracked. Okay, back to stretching. At 0 seconds, Billy starts walking, and at 1 second, he's 5 centimeters towards his goal. That's when we stretch the rope another 10 centimeters, and then Billy moves, I can't stretch the rope and move Billy at the same time. I really need like another arm or something like, whoa, hey, no, hey, no, 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 come back, mystery arm. I need your help, look, just hold this end of the rope like that, and then, yeah, this is frightening, but helpful. Now after this stretch, the rope is 30 centimeters long, and look, Billy's no longer at 5 centimeters because the key to all of this is that the ant is on the rope and he stretches with the rope. So to make sure he moves exactly 5 centimeters each second, I'll just grab another ruler. There we go, Billy moves another 5 centimeters, and now we stretch to 40 centimeters. Billy moves another 5, 50 centimeters, another 5 for Billy, 60 centimeters, 5 more for Billy, 70 centimeters, and you can see that despite stretching the rope much more than the ground he covers each second, Billy is making progress toward the end. So a 5 centimeter speed and 10 centimeter stretch really isn't much of a paradox here either. But what if we stretch the rope 1 kilometer and Billy moves at only a 1 centimeter per second pace? And we stretch it 1 kilometer every second. Then can Billy ever reach the end of the rope? Obviously not. Or definitely yes. And there's our paradox. Ant on a rubber rope is a veridical paradox, which we learned about in my What is a Paradox video. It's the type of paradox that packs a surprise because obviously the ant can't reach the end of the rope if we stretch it that much every second, but that certainty dissipates as we ponder the proof. Actually, if I stretch it 1 kilometer per second and the ant only moves 1 centimeter per second, he will still reach the end, as long as old Billy here lives forever. Okay, let's ponder that proof. It's important to think about this as the fraction of the rope that Billy has left to travel instead of the raw distance. I'll show you. Let's put Billy at the halfway mark of the rope, like that, and then I'm just gonna mark where he's standing with the Sharpie on the rope, okay? So that mark is our Billy. And this time Billy doesn't move at all, he just stands there being Billy. Every time we stretch the rope, distance is added behind and in front of the rope, but he's still at the halfway point because his relative position doesn't change, which means that in spite of the stretching, every time Billy steps forward from this point, he's making progress toward reaching the end of the rubber rope. By continuing his journey forward, he can only get closer to the end. And eventually, he will, because he's always shrinking the fraction of the rope he has left. If you still don't believe this, then we can totally get algebra-y and calculicious. First, I want to briefly mention the harmonic series. It's a divergent series, meaning the partial sums of the series don't have a finite limit. It was first proven over 600 years ago, and there's been a whole list of different proofs since that I'll link you to down in the description below. But the important thing to know is that it's like a never-ending addition problem where the sum of these fractions eventually surpasses one. Okay, let's talk about Billy and his stretching rope. Let's say the rope is initially C units long and the ant moves A units toward the other end of the rope every second, but the rope itself stretches V units longer every single second. During the first second, the ant will have moved A units forward and the rope will have stretched C plus V units long. Cool? Cool. In the second second, the ant will again move A units forward, and the rope stretches another V units longer, making its new length its original length, C plus V again, which we could just write as C plus 2V. In the third second, the ant will have moved another A units forward, and the rope will be C plus VVV units long, or C plus 3V. During any second, the fraction of the rope the ant covers is just the ratio between the two lengths in that second's row. After the first second, the ant covers A units of the total C plus V units the rope is long. During the second second, the ant covers A units of the rope's now total C plus 2V units of length, and so on. If you add these two fractions, you get the fraction of the rope covered after the first and second second. The number of fractions we add corresponds to how many seconds have elapsed, and their sum tells us the total fraction of the rope the ant has covered after that many seconds. One way to think about adding fractions to represent a sum is eating pizza, okay? Take one big bite of pizza and then a smaller bite of pizza. Add those two bites together and their sum equals the total amount of pizza you've just eaten. So if we represent seconds as k, during the kth second, the ant covers one of the total C plus KV units the rope is long. Okay, cool story, Kevin, but the question is, if we wait long enough, if we add up enough of these diminishing fractions of the rope's length the ant covers during each next second, will the sum ever equal one? One whole of the rope's length? Yes. And we could prove that by using a comparison test. Let's compare this series with one whose behavior we know, the harmonic series. We could do that by creatively tweaking the general formula for the fraction of the rope the ant covers during any given second k. If we multiply not only v, but also c by k. Then for any natural number k, like 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., this new formula will give us either the same result as the original formula. Well, it'll give us the same result when k equals 1, because if k equals 1, then this is just c, and if k equals 1 here, that's just v, so that will be the same, so that will be equal. Or it'll give us a number that is smaller. And this new formula, a over kc plus kv, is equal to a over C plus V times 1 over K. Because 1 times A is just A, and then we still have the K times C and K times V. Okay? Got it? And if we generate a new series using this formula, when we start plugging in numbers for K, we get A over C plus V times 1 over 1, plus 1 over 2, plus 1 over 3, plus 1 over 4, and so on. Which is the harmonic series. Exciting. So this new series we've created diverges. As long as you keep adding in new values for bigger and bigger k's, the sum can reach any number you want, including one. It's a big one. And since, because this is a big deal, because since every element of this new series is always equal to or less than an element in the series that describes the ant's progress, our ant's progress must also diverge. So no matter how tiny the fractions get, no matter how long it takes the ant to cover any proportion of the rope, he will eventually cover 1/1 of whatever the rope's length has become. He will reach the end. But it'll take a long, long time since a smaller and smaller portion is covered every step of the way. In our example of an ant traveling 1 centimeter every second and a rope stretching 1 kilometer longer every second, the ant will reach the end after about 8.9 times 10 raised to the 43,421 years. To put that number in perspective, the known universe is about 13.8 billion years old, which is 1.38 times 10 to the 10. All the known atoms in the observable universe is about 10 raised to the 80, and a goo gall is still only 10 to the 100. So, what does a number with 43,421 zeros actually look like? This. The real-world analog to the ant on a rubber rope would be light from distant galaxies traveling through space. If photons are traveling through a universe that is constantly expanding, will their light ever reach Earth? The ant on a rubber rope teaches us that yes, yes, the light will eventually reach us. Or it would if the universe were expanding at a constant rate. But the metric expansion of the universe is actually accelerating, which means there are ant photons traveling through the universe's rubber rope that will never crawl into your eyes. So be sure to enjoy the starlight that does make that journey. And as always, thanks for watching.